I mean, right now we're using roughly like 40,000 sq ft of it. The building's 400,000 sq ft. So 2,500 to 3,500 metric tons of rare earth oxides is just the starting point. We'll be substantially larger than that here in the next few years.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Mark Jensen. He is the CEO of American Resources Corp. And Mark, it's good to see you again. How are you?
I'm doing great.
You've got a couple of areas of operation going on. You've got a couple, one plant that's running like right to the max, and then you've got another plant that's in soon to be in operation. So maybe you could sort of talk to us a little bit about today's news that gave a bit of an update on where you're at.
Yeah, absolutely. So we wanted to share with some of our partners and a lot of our strategic partners the scale that we're at in Marion. I think we publicly stated we're building out to 2,000 metric tons of separated purified rare earth oxides annually. And based on the designs and some optimization we've done with the same CapEx, we're closer to 2,500 and in certain instances, 3,500 metric tons of rare earth oxides, which gets to about that 10,000 metric tons of magnet capacity.
Yeah, so that's it at Marion. I know that you're ramping up production at Noblesville as well. So, are you taking some of the things that you've learned from Noblesville to put them into Marion?
Yeah, absolutely. Noblesville is all about optimization. Obviously, right now we're scaling for production from the magnet business as well as a lot of the defense elements, the germanium, gallium that we need to produce out of Noblesville. But the what we've learned over the last 5 years in Noblesville is helping us design Marion more efficiently. Apologize, got some background here from some construction we have going on here.
Yeah. Talk to me a little bit about the space that you have. I know this is a big facility at Marion, and you're using a portion of it right now, but you hope to use as much of it as you eventually can down the road, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, right now we're using roughly like 40,000 square feet of it. The building's 400,000 square feet. So 2,500 to 3,500 metric tons of earth oxides is just the starting point. Will be substantially larger than that here in the next few years.
Yeah, I want to ask you about you mentioned the news release about the columns and the difference in size and why that's so significant between what you're doing at Noblesville and what's going on at Marion. Can you sort of, so people would understand what the columns do and why the dimensions are so different?
Yeah, so the columns we're using in Noblesville are 18 inches in diameter. The columns we're using in Marion are 60 to 63 inches in diameter, but you get a multiplication factor of that. So it's not just a one-for-one scale. You get to significantly higher capacity based on the volume and the cubic meters of resin in those columns. It's a magnitude of 2 to 3x of capacity, which is huge.
Yeah. Mark, is there anyone that does what you do in the United States? Like how dominant can you become with the work that you're doing, obviously now and eventually at Marion?
Yeah, I mean, we control the exclusive worldwide rights to simulated movie bed continuous chromatography. We have 12 additional patents that are in the works right now that we'll file on. If anybody's doing what we do, we got a problem. We'd have to defend our patents, but everybody else is looking at solvent extraction and modified versions of solvent extraction, which is just not versatile, scalable, where for us, we can build based on current demand and then scale it in a 3 to 6 month period to meet that future demand using columns and production lines versus building massive mixers and settlers that may not be economically viable in the next 5 years.
Well, exciting times ahead, and the build continues. Mark, thanks for giving us a quick update. Really appreciate the time.
That sounds good. Thank you so much.
All right, Mark Jensen, the CEO of American Resources Corp.